Okay, first of all, Toastmaster Kawakami, you never told me about the number of the people. So if I knew it, I wouldn't be a speaker today. So everybody, I'm only a CC finisher, ALB. Please cheer me up. And collaborate with me. Okay? So ladies and gentlemen of Taiwan and Japan, I have a question for you. Can you make an arrangement for your travel only through the internet by yourself? Yes? Maybe yes. Okay, so recently, it's getting much more easier for me to make a, you know, arrangement by the internet because I don't have to look at the contract like this. You know what I mean? So, the tour desk is my speech title today. The tour desk. It's so hard to find people who only go to the actual tour desk. Don't you agree? Okay, so do you think the tour desk is a dying breed? Of course not. They are existing. So I stopped by at the one of the tourists in Tokyo these days, and I want to share my experience with you today. So just imagine I am in the office of the tour agency. There is an old couple in front of me and making a line for the desk. And finally, their turn comes along. So, the conversation with them and the personnel at the desk was so fascinating. Just like this. Okay, may I help you? Well, you know, we are planning to go to Taipei next month. Certainly. So we can make an arrangement for you. When would you like to? Well, you know, as you see, we kind of old. So that's the earlier, the better. Certainly. So we have a flight at 6 o'clock in the morning. Would you like that? Sure, sure. So, we can take that, please. Then, suddenly, his wife tried to rebuke him. Hey, my dear. Is there anything wrong? Yes. He forgot, totally forgot to tell you about, you know, as a matter of fact, we have a grandson. He's living in Australia. We want to take him to Taipei with us. Oh, I see, really? I understand now. So you are going to Taipei, and at the same time, you want to invite your grandson to go over to Taipei, and you meet here together, right? Yes, but actually, he's only 9 years old. So, we wanna pick him up at the Sydney airport. Okay. So you are going to pick him up at the Sydney airport. And then, three of you will head to Taipei. Is that right? Yes, but actually, his mother, it means our daughter, She's living in Los Angeles. And we want to take her also. Okay, let's see. So you are going to type in VIA Sydney, right? And at the same time, you want to invite your daughter from LA to Taipei. And your folks will be reunited in Taipei. Is that your plan? Yes. Actually, since they have been separated for years, so we want to take our grandson to LA and make his mother surprised. What happened to you, your family? Well, do we have to tell you? Oh, no. Sorry, forget it. Excuse my question. Okay, let me make another arrangement for you right now. Okay, from Narita to Sydney for two. Then Sydney to LA for three. Then LA to Taipei for four. Wow. It's go around ticket. Oh, it seems so fantastic to me. Okay. I made it. Okay. Oh, wow. It will take you 5 days to get there from Narita. And it will cost you a lot of money. And besides, it will cost you physically, I guess. Well, now, who else? It's not really. My husband and I have a habit of taking a nap for our health. So it's been since we are here for a long time. We're gonna take a break and excuse us and we'll be back soon. Good day! Hey, customer! Hey, folks, please come back! Now everybody is the scene from Impressive Memory of the Traditional Tourist. Why don't you stop by sometimes and enjoy and the experience of same kind? Thank you, Ghostmaster.
Fellow Toastmaster from Taiwan and Japan. I am so glad that Takako took the direct flight from Yokohama to Taiwan. She didn't have to stop in Australia or before she came to Taiwan. Otherwise, you'll have to wait for 4 or 5 days. First of all, I'd like to congratulate Takako for her bravery in taking up a humorous speech project in an occasion like this. She's challenging the Asian's gene. It was said that Asians don't have humor in their genes, but she has the courage to do that. As a DTM, I'm still working on humor speech. So for that, I give my deepest respect. She has a way to open up a speech by self-deprecating, saying that she didn't know this occasion. So in that way, she set the tone of her speech and also relaxed the audience. The highlight of her speech is in the conversation in the old couples that she delivered in a very dynamic way in mimicking how the old people were talking. And also her vocal variety, her body language, and her heart is all in the conversation. And I think that was very good. And that was the meat of the whole speech. And what I sense is that there's a compassion behind this conversation. Because you could easily say the old people are so out of date, they don't know the technology, they're taking up other people's time. But she had a way to look at that, and with a compassion and delivered into a humorous way. So I thought that was wonderfully, wonderfully done. And that occasion was also very familiar to us. So it's not difficult to picture what she was talking about. If I were to give a suggestion, I would tie that tour desk into a scenario of perhaps you're purchasing a ticket to come into Taipei, and this is what I overheard, or this is what I saw, a couple interaction. Maybe I would also add, while this couple are taking up so much time from the worker, there's people behind them who are losing patience. They were starting to talk about other things. Just add some jokes into that time of waiting. Maybe that will make the humor speech more. I want to ask you, were you entertained by her speech?
Yes.
I counted 14 times of laughter. So that's almost like 30 seconds per laughter. It's a classic formula. And every time the old couple says, actually, then you can expect another joke coming up. And she was good to wait for people to laugh. So you give us time and space. So that was wonderful. So what I learned from you is, besides the delivering skills, the jokes, I think most importantly in humor speech is the heart to observe ordinary things and turn the ordinary things into a humor, into appreciation of life. And that is compassion. So thank you for giving us this wonderful speech. Thank you.